Hey guys, what's going on? It is Dan Lags, and welcome back to part number 3 of Let's Build a Battle Mode Arena. So guys, last episode I was working on the cave, and I have a couple of updates to give you guys on the cave, and then a few other things in the arena. We'll start off with the cave, I guess, but basically I just added a little bit more snow to the exterior of it, just a little bit more detailing. On the inside, I pretty much put it in. So we have like a floor of snow, like of just random layers. And then we have some icicles hanging down from the ceiling, some pretty large icicles. And then pretty much the rest of the wall is going to be stone and snow. And I might mix in some other things and some more details later on, but this is kind of like the foundation of it. And I also was able to fix the lighting defects inside of the cave as well. It looks like I actually missed a spot right here. So look at all this extra space that I need to cover up. Let me just throw an extra snow block right up here, patch that up, and that's good. Might even just get rid of that block, but yeah, this is the inside of the cave. I think it's looking pretty good. So again, like I said, I'll add probably more detail to this later. I'm not sure yet. I think I want to try to add some sort of like ice monster. I'm not really sure how I'd do that in Minecraft. And it would just be like aesthetic, I guess, but we'll have to just kind of figure that out later, but that's like the interior of the cave, and of course we have the exit down through the water, like kind of like the back entrance. And I had to add a few more like glowing blocks, or what are these called again? Sea lanterns. That's right. I keep forgetting that. I had to add a few more of those because the ice was just reappearing. So kind of unfortunate to have that light there, but it's not the end of the world. As you can see, like look, the ice is already starting to form. It kind of like goes in and out right there, but I'm not really too worried about it. But anyway. We also have a tree here, so I'm just doing some experimenting with some trees, and this is, I think it's pretty good. I don't know if it's perfect, but this was kind of just like the first tree I built, so I'll make improvements to the tree design, you know, as we add more of them, because I want to put like maybe 7 or 8 of these throughout the entire arena. We have one right there. I actually have a one that's been like not chopped down, but like it fell over because maybe it had too much snow on it or something. So, like, there's, like, the original trunk, and then it's kind of falling, crashing into the water, I guess, and then it got frozen over. So, just to add some, you know, little things that just add some more detail to the arena is what I'm looking for. So, that's pretty good, and what the heck? Oh, wow, the waterfall froze. What the heck? Okay, that's weird. I don't know. I did not expect that, but I guess the waterfall for some reason froze. That's kind of weird. Anyway, we gotta open that up as well, but we'll let that flow back down. That should be fine. Yeah, I guess the top parts here must have gotten stagnant or something, and it froze over. Really weird. Anyway, doesn't really matter, but it's back to how it was now. But yeah, anyway, that's the updates that I did in between episodes. Just a couple of small things. And I didn't really work on the walls too much. I might do a little bit of like speed up wall work towards the end of this video. Because this part over here, like where there's like a higher area, like this is going to be pretty much like a mountain. So I'm going to have like this really tall part of the, I guess, the wall. And then for the rest of the area, I'm going to have what I think I'm going to put the log cabin over in this corner. And then I'm going to put an igloo over here. And I'm just going to have like random trees and ice spikes kind of mixed in. So we have like that tree. I'll probably put another one there. A couple more over there. A couple more over there. Just, you know, randomly assorted. But anyway, today's episode, the goal is to build the igloo. I'm going to do that today. And we'll get started on that. Also, I put like these little borders here on the spawn points. Just so you couldn't like fly off the side potentially. So I think it even makes it look a little bit better as well. So that works. But anyway, let's go ahead and get started by making an igloo today. So I'm going to build it like over here somewhere, and I'll start with the back because, again, we're going to have the borders of these walls coming through. So I have to keep that in mind and make sure that I'm not bonking into those. So I'll probably do it like right here. I think that's probably a pretty good spot. That'll be, if I actually take the packed ice down, I can get a general idea of how close it's going to be to the wall. This is not like a set in stone thing. Like, as you can see, the wall sticks out a little bit more out here in the front. But if it's like 5 blocks away like it is right there, you know, I'm totally okay with that. So we'll just roll with that. We got 4 blocks here. Let's do 5. Let's do 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 1, 2. All right, is that going to be a good enough size? Is that like even like a circle? you know how it's hard to build circles in Minecraft? I don't know if that's going to be... It's kind of hard for me to tell, like, with the contrast of colors. Let me put a ring of packed ice on top of that, just so I can see the contrast, and maybe that'll help me determine this a little bit better. But I'm going to make a decent-sized igloo, and it's going to be inhabited by somebody or something. I'll probably maybe put, like, a villager in there. I don't know, but it doesn't really matter. But as far as, like, a circle goes, I think that works. That's good enough for me, so we'll go with that. And I'm gonna just kind of build like a semicircle, kind of a dome looking thing as this big igloo, and it should be pretty cool. So it's gonna be, I guess, kind of similar to the cave. And by the way, the cave from like over here looks pretty fancy. I'm a fan of the way the cave turned out, so I'm just a fan of this entire arena in general. I think once this thing is done, it's going to be, like, honestly, one of the coolest things I've built. Like, I just am really hyped to build this. It's been a lot of fun. But anyway, let's get this igloo put in. So I'm going to do, like, 3 levels here. Probably more than this later, but we'll start with 3. It'll be a 3x5 wall on each one of these sides. And then I think I'm going to do... actually, I might make these 4. Make these 4. Make the rest of them 3, but... I've done something relatively similar to this way back in the day on my castle let's build, kind of these semicircle dome-shaped things, so I guess it does kind of apply for this igloo design. So it should work out pretty nice. Alright, that's 3 blocks tall there. We're just adding 2 more levels to it. And let's go ahead and do like 1 block there, 1 block there. And then I'm going to kind of curl this in like that on the corner there. Might even take that block out and place these few blocks down into the corner there. I think that's pretty good. So we'll do something like that. Let me go ahead and continue that on each one of these sides. But yeah, if I can get this igloo done today, that'd be awesome. Again, I'm in no rush to kind of build this stuff because I'm giving myself, you know, around 10 episodes to build this. So you know, I don't think it's going to take that long, honestly. I think I'll probably have it done by like 6 or 7. But with adding detail and things like that, again, I don't want to rush myself. I want to make something really cool here, and I think I already have a really good start. It's always great when, I think I talked about this a little bit, but it's always great when you have like a vision for what you want to build, because it just kind of, if you're able to execute like your idea in your head, like in Minecraft, the way you thought about it originally, it just really is a great feeling. So it's always nice when you think about something like, oh, that would be so cool to build, and then you actually go to try to build it and it turns out the way you thought. Probably one of my favorite things about building stuff. So so far so good on this build. It's like pretty much exactly how I'd hoped it would be, so we'll just kind of continue that, and hopefully it'll turn out the way I wanted when it's completely done. But anyway, we're gonna add more to this igloo, and really my next step is to kind of take this in a layer and start to turn it around this corner. Let's see here, why is this not right? Oh yeah, because I didn't do this corner yet. That makes a little bit more sense. So we'll fill that in right there. Fill that in right there. So I'm going to take that over the top. I don't know yet. I think I probably end up will doing that. So I guess we'll just kind of continue that down. Have it wrap around and run across right here. And we'll kind of just see where this goes from here. But let's get this second level figured out first, and then we'll go from there. But let's see. All right, there we go. Take a look at it from the front. So my whole goal for this is just to kind of make it, you know, like a dome shape. So far, not super great. I think it might be a little bit too tall on the bottom, but these are things that we can adjust as we go. So I'm not super concerned right off the bat. Again, this is kind of like just the start of it. So, you know, I can always change it up, but so far, I think it's fine. I would like to do something with this, maybe do that. I think that could look pretty good. Really just depends. We're just gonna have to figure this out. So we'll put those 2 blocks there. That'll kind of leave that corner. Let's do these 4, place those 2. Yeah, there's really no rhyme or reason to this, actually. It's just kind of, I have to kind of create the pattern as I go. It's not like a thing where I'll perfect it probably the first time. It's probably gonna take a couple of changes to get it perfect, but it's not too bad so far. I think it kind of works. Again, now I got to start to get this thing filled in on the top and actually like make it look like an igloo, right? So let's do that. All right, so kind of wrap it around this corner. run across and have it go down this way. Okay, let's see. All right, so for this next level, I probably want to take this in two blocks all the way around. So let me finish it off over here and then I can do that. Okay, so we'll take that across there. So that's two blocks. And there as well. And what's going on right there? That, oh yeah, that's because that block's right there. Can get rid of that block, get rid of this block. Okay, so something like that. And then I'll probably end up adding a couple blocks on each one of these corners. Like this, and then add another level here. Take it around town. Hopefully this will work. I'm hoping it'll work first time. I'm just worried it might not look like an igloo right away. It might not be like dome-shaped enough. I was gonna say domey enough, but I don't think that's a word. But hopefully it'll be okay. So that's kind of like what I'm hoping for. And I'm gonna be completely honest, you guys. That's not actually that bad. Like I can work with that pretty good. I probably will end up making some small tweaks to it, like maybe adding like a couple of extra blocks here on these corners. You know, like stuff like that possibly. Maybe not even there, maybe like right here. Just so it looks a little bit more dome shaped. I think that actually does work pretty well. So let me just do something like that real quick. Add that in around the corners. Just because, again, I want it to be as dome shaped as possible. And I think my first run through, although it's okay, I don't think it's perfect. I think that does help it though a little bit, what I just did there. Actually, that helps it a good amount, actually. I think that looks a lot better than it did just like 5 seconds ago, but let's go ahead and add an entrance. I think that'll help make it look a little bit more like an igloo if I can add an entrance. So it just gives you guys a visualization a little bit more. But igloo entrances are kind of pretty simple, aren't they? Just like something like that. Nothing too fancy. I would like to get out my snow caps here because I believe that these are going to be very, very useful in the long run. Because I can use these to kind of shape the dome a little bit more if I need to, like make small adjustments. And it'll also help me with this this part right here, which I think I have right so far. I think it's like six blocks. So this last one's incorrect. Make that, oops, I just messed it up again. There we go. So that would be, I guess, the entrance to the igloo. I just love saying the word igloo. It's just a great word, but what I'll probably end up doing is something like that, right? But yeah, it looks pretty good in here. Very dome-shaped on the inside. This, there's no issues in there. And I think the outside is adequate. Certainly adequate. I don't know if it's perfect, but I mean, we can add things to it. You know, I can take up levels of snow to kind of just give it more of a dome shape. I can do that throughout. And of course, I'm going to come in and start to put all the kind of like the snow layering that I'm going to be doing throughout the entire arena. I'm going to be coming through and adding all of this throughout. You know, pretty much like what I've been doing over there and over there and over there as well. Pretty much everywhere, actually, is going to have like the, just like random layers of snow, right? Nothing, you know, there's nothing here that's kind of just set in stone. It's really just random placement of blocks. But that's what I really like about building snow biome theme stuff is because, you know, you have so much more ability to detail things with the ability to stack snow, because you can just cover stuff in snow and it just looks snowy. You know, I can take anything, just cover it with these snow pads or whatever you want to call them, the layers of snow, and it just makes them look snowy, right? it's honestly like really nice. So it just creates a lot of detail, and it's another one of the reasons why I chose this theme for the battle mode arena. But yeah, the igloo is a good thing. Will it be like balanced for the battle mode? I that's yet to be seen. You know, that's something I'll figure out later and I'll adjust it accordingly. Because as of right now, like if I'm thinking about it in terms of like how it would play, you know, if you were to go inside of this igloo, right? And actually you can't even get in at its current state. Let me just kind of make it so it's actually like you can get inside. There we go. But in its current state, right? You know, if you were in here, I'm just gonna put a light just so it's a little bit brighter in here. How would you get out, right? If you got stuck in here and someone was coming in behind you, how would you get out? Okay, so do I make like possibly like a crack in the back of the igloo with like an ice or something? Like, or maybe I was thinking about something cool, like maybe doing like an ice spike grew up through like the side of it, and it has like a crack in the wall. Because I am going to be adding the ice spikes, like a standard ice spike biome ice spike later on. But actually, now that I'm looking at this from a distance, that looks very igloo-y to me. I don't really think you would mistake that for anything else. So I'll definitely sign up for that. But it's looking pretty good. And then as far as like out front, in front of the igloo, I would like to add some sort of fire pit. Okay. So let me try that out. What am I looking for right now? Netherrack. That's right. I was just like spacing out for a second. All right. So I'm going to get some flint, steel, and some netherrack. And I think maybe like right here, I'm going to place a netherrack actually into the ground a little bit. And this is like, oh boy, you know, this is going to melt the snow. Like, the fire is the snow. It's like its worst enemy, right? It's just going to melt it all over the place. But what I want to do is actually pretty much put like a kind of like a little hole in the ground. Not necessarily like a hole, but I mean, yeah, pretty much just a hole in the ground. And this is where, you know, the inhabitants of this igloo, you know, they can sit in here, gather around the campfire, and, you know, just get warm, I guess. But we'll do something like that. And then, again, the snow will kind of continue around. I can't put the snow caps too close because, you know, obviously it's going to melt. But, you know, I can just kind of just wrap it around a little bit, and it should be pretty nice. So, kind of, like, in here, I'm thinking about maybe putting in some like coal blocks mixed in around this, because it's really doesn't make sense for it to have snow in here. Maybe I could even do some wood, possibly. This would probably, I guess, that would probably burn, right? I don't know. Is fire spread on? No, it's not. So I think that'll be okay. But that's kind of like something I want to do. And I was thinking maybe even I could do some like some sort of sitting area or something. I don't know. I kind of like that though. Just a little fire pit in the ground out in the front of the igloo. And as far as sitting areas are concerned, I think I'm going to do something like this. I think this is a pretty sound idea. I'm going to do a couple of like sideways logs as little seats. You know, just it's the subtle life, right? So let's put that in. And I'll just kind of do like three of those around. We're going to have a tree right there probably. In fact, what I should do, not necessarily build the trees right now, but at least get the spots marked for where they're going to be. So they're going to be pretty tall, like almost as tall as the arena, maybe a little bit shorter than that. So let's say like it'll be something like that, right? So we'll have a tree there. I think I'll put another one right here, take it on up to, you know, a given height. We'll determine how exactly tall it's going to be later. I'll put another one right here, and I'll probably end up putting another one over here next to the cave, and probably like two or three more over here. And then I'm also going to mix ice spikes into the biome. So let's say we use the packed ice. I'll put one ice spike right here. Again, I'll add the actual detail to it later. In fact, I have to go like look at an ice spike biome for like memory, just so I can, because I want to make like an exact ice spike, right? Like exactly what you would see. So we'll put one right there. I'll probably add like a few more over here, just kind of like random. And then I might even, like I said earlier, put like an ice spike that's going straight out of the like the igloo, it, like grew through it or something. I don't know. And that's like how you would escape the back, because, you know, we have an escape in the back of the cave, so it's not a dead end. So we want the same thing for the igloo. But it's looking pretty good right now. Definitely something that I can work with. What I want to do actually is build one of these trees, and I think I'm gonna do it next to the igloo, because I want to kind of complete this area. Not complete this area, but at least make it look like there's been some progress, so I can at least evaluate it to see if like how much I like it or not. But basically for these spruce trees, right? They're kind of just these amplified regular spruce trees, right? You just picture a regular spruce tree. It kind of has like the layers of spruce leaves. What I'm building here is, like I said, basically just like a super version of it, like an amplified, supersized version of a typical spruce tree that you would find. But kind of have like layers to it here, so I've been kind of taking some layers up around the sides, and it looks pretty good, I think. Again, it's not the perfect tree. You know, I'm no pro at building trees. It's never been something that I've been like super great at, mainly because I usually like to just plant like standard trees and like just go with that. You know, like the trees that the game can just give you, just spawning with bone meal, honestly. I've never really been a custom tree builder, so this is something that, again, I don't have a ton of experience in, but I still think I can pull off something that will work. But we'll go ahead and kind of continue this. And I like to have three layers. Might have a couple of smaller trees that only have two, but again, that's something that, you know, we can figure out later. But we'll do the last layer right here. And this one, I try to make them a little bit smaller as they go up, but I don't really think it matters. I think they look fine if they're all, even if they're all the same size. But that'll be the third layer, and then this one will just kind of go all the way up. And I've added a few spruce leaves above the top of the log, and that is kind of what I want to do with it, like right there. Let me just take a step back here, take a look at it. So not too bad. I think I want to make it just so it like lines up with that tree a little bit more. I think I need to add a few more leaves, like branching it out a little bit more. And also, yeah, I just have to make it wider. It's too skinny in its current state, but it's a good start. This tree will work just fine. I just gotta make it a little bit wider, but it'll definitely work. But yeah, guys, that's pretty much what I want to build for today's episode of Battle Mode, of the Battle Mode Let's Build. Making some good progress on this for sure. I'll add more trees in between episodes, and next episode I believe I'm going to either start working on that mountain possibly, or if I don't work on that, then I might make some progress, possibly get started on a log cabin, because again, I want to add that as well. Just everything that you can think of that you would find in like a snowy region is going to be on this battle mode seed. So it should be pretty cool. So let me just add, I'm adding a little bit more detail to this, because I think it's going to be something that it will help out the build quite a bit. This top level needs a little bit more thickness to it. Needs to be a little bit wider, and I think it'll be good. But yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching this episode. I really appreciate it. Thank you guys for the support in the series thus far. This has been like probably one of my favorite Let's Builds I've done in a while. I'm only three episodes into it. I just really enjoy it. This is something like, it's just something different than building like houses or skyscrapers or something like that. But it's been a lot of fun thus far. But let me take a step back and look at the improved tree. Now that right there is a tree. I'm a big fan of that. So that's looking pretty good. Let me just do one last thing before I wrap up today's episode. I'm going to grab some snow and some snow caps or whatever we call it. I think I determined on my stream what I was going to officially call these, because they're both called snow. So you kind of like, how do you differentiate between them if you need to? And I think I don't know. I always used to call these snow caps, and the other one's just regular snow blocks. But people are just telling me to call these blocks that I'm using right now snow, and then like the full block a snow block. So it'd be snow and snow blocks, which I think is how the game should name them. But you know, I'm not the one making up the terminology, but I've always been calling them snow caps. So I'll probably end up saying that a lot on you know, without even realizing. But it doesn't really matter, right? You guys pretty much get the idea. But I'm gonna add a few more of these, just kind of randomly placed. Again, the thing about it is, if I start the snowing, it'll actually just kind of place on all the blocks that don't have it already. So it's really just me about layering more than just actually getting them on every block. But I think that'll be pretty good in terms of just getting the snow on it looking good. So we have two of those trees in. I'll probably, again, all those spots where I designated tree areas, I will add those in later. But last thing I want to do is turn on the snow, because this is how it would be played. And you start right here. I mean, this is a cool spot right here, right? Because you see like the cave, got some trees, the igloos over there. I think this is looking great so far. I'm really happy with it. So guys, thank you so much for watching this episode. It's been Dan Lags, Battle Mode Arena Episode 3, and we're calling it Frost. So I'll see you guys for Episode 4. I'll make a little bit more progress off camera, and we will continue next episode. So give this video a like rating if you did enjoy it, guys. Thanks for watching. It's been Dan Lags, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace out.